in San Francisco, we had an interview with Laila Tretikov. She's the executive director of the Wikimedia Foundation. You can watch the video of the interview at our YouTube channel, youtube.com/CarlExpedition. And don't forget to subscribe, of course. Wikipedia, Wikimedia Foundation, because Wikimedia Foundation is doing quite some really cool stuff. Some facts from their own page, the Wikipedia page. They got about 8 billion page views and almost 500 million unique visitors each month. That's our figures from February 2014, so that's quite impressive. Globally, they got over 90 million accounts, out of which were 69,000 active editors in November 2014, so it's really an active community. Like I said, Wikimedia Foundation is a broad foundation where the Wikipedia project on the website is part of, but they're doing also quite some other cool stuff. And they're also really transparent about what they're doing and how they do it. So also what Laila said was, okay, we have no secrets, but there's a lot to understand. And that's, I think, the best way to summarize what's happening at Wikimedia Foundation in one sentence. In this reference video, I will share my main lessons learned from the interview and also some food for thought and challenges for the Wikimedia Foundation for the future. First, the main lessons. The only reason why Wikipedia, let's talk about the Wikipedia website, could grow this fast and has so many users is that it's only is driven by facilitating others. So facilitating others to create. And that's something we see with lots of new media organizations like YouTube, like Google, but also in the sharing economy with Airbnb. They don't create things themselves, but they facilitate others. They're giving them the tools and a platform to do, and also giving them the vision. And like the foundations, they care of the service like software, hosting, funds, program grants, and legal support. And everything they do it in a really practical way because they got not so many people working for them, so they have to redo also. Make things automatic, like bots are scanning to check the quality of the articles. It's also a really good example of that technology is really important, because without technology, Wikipedia couldn't exist. But the human factor is even more important, and that's something I see with quite some corporates who are trying to build their own platform, because they say, okay, we can also build our own platform. But with only building the technique and the platform, that won't make you successful, especially the human. So the human part is first, and then comes the technique. That's, I think, a really important lesson also from Wikimedia. And there's also a really big why. So they are united by passion, by openness, and they know everybody who is participating in the Wikimedia project is bigger than the sum of its parts. They got a really clear vision and a clear meaning about that. And of course, everybody is contributing from its own motivations and also from its own ego. But in the end, the total sum of the part of all the contributions is the most important thing with the Wikimedia Foundation. I think we can learn from that. So put your ego aside. And so when you have really clear what you want to achieve, then it's also easier for people to contribute. Some food for thought and some challenges. They got a really dedicated crowd. They're busy, really actively busy on the platform by adding and also by checking articles. And it's really hard sometimes to make a change when you have such a dedicated crowd, because they got a really great feel of ownership of their also responsible for Wikimedia and Wikipedia, and this is really cool, and this is their biggest force, of course, because that's the only way to create such a cool thing. But it's also a challenge because it's really hard as an organization to try to change something, because you got a really dedicated crowd that also feels really responsible for what they're doing. And of course, in the future, we see a huge change of media consumption. One side about how people or on which devices people are consuming media. Like Laila said, with Wikipedia in the US, the balance between mobile and desktop is 50-50. So 50% of all visitors on Wikipedia is by using mobile. Besides that, we see a change in media consumption. People, Wikipedia has quite some long texts. And I think that in the future that will change in a much shorter texts, but also in different kind of media like video and audio. And that will bring some changes for them with it. And one times the capacity of the servers, because they all want to have on their own servers, and text is quite light to back up. Video is quite a challenge for that. But also with the type of crowds that are now participating in building Wikipedia. Because I guess that when you need shorter texts, but also when you need audio and video, you also need another crowd. So I think the challenge for the future is how to get the crowd that also goes along with the new type of media we're using and we're going to use in the future, because nobody knows where it's heading to. Now, like you said, knowledge comes in all kinds of forms. So we've got short text, video, audio. So it's really important also to get the right crowd for that, because else you won't have an audience to check your content. The other thing, second thing, food for thought challenge for the future, I think, is the business model. They're now running a donation program. It runs whole year, and all their expenses are being paid by donations. And that's really, really impressive. Really impressive, but I think it's also a threat, because in the end, when Wikipedia is less cool or less used, then it's also a big challenge, because then there's also the possibility to be that the donations will go down, and also people are seeing a really successful website, and so the need of a sense of urgency to give money. Because hey, there's already a good website, so why should I give money? It's also a challenge. So I think that will be a good thing to think about in the future. Of course, you told me there is also a plan B, but I'm really curious about what that plan B will be. But so that's also a point of action to make it also a sustainable model for the future. But in the end, overall, looking at what they are doing, it's really impressive what they can do with such a small team, with such a small staff, creating really great things for other people to create value. So thumbs up for that.